Before we discuss the words that you see behind me, I want to tell you something about what's happening in Pakistan. After selling its land to Chinese projects, Islamabad is now selling the seas to Beijing. Chinese vessels have been allowed to fish in Pakistan's exclusive economic zone. None of this should be news because by now, most of the world knows that China practically owns Pakistan. But it's news because of some surprising developments in Karachi. Pakistani citizens are out by the hundreds protesting against China. They are mostly Pakistani fishermen. They are protesting against the arrival of 20 deep sea trawlers from China. These trawlers arrived in the first week of August, and they have been permitted to fish off the coasts of Sindh and Balochistan. Pakistani fishermen do not want the Chinese to fish in their waters. They say today these vessels might deprive them of a good catch, but tomorrow they may end up destroying the entire ecological environment of the waters. And they're right. According to the Pakistan Fisher Folk Forum, fish stocks in coastal areas have already declined by more than 72% since last year. 72%. This is largely due to uncontrolled fishing. And now these people fear that Chinese trawlers will make things worse, and they have a fair point. According to some estimates, fishing is a source of livelihood for more than 2.5 million people in Pakistan's coastal towns. These fishermen use small boats that cannot venture into deep waters, but Chinese trawlers can. And they're equipped with large fishing nets. They can capture fish in bigger numbers. And given that the vessels are Chinese, one can only imagine the predatory practices they indulge in at the expense of Pakistanis. The Chinese are known for their insatiable appetite for seafood. They account for 1/3 of the world's consumption. Nothing to be proud of here. China's own stocks around its coasts have depleted because of this. Beijing's giant trawlers are increasingly looking for new avenues, for new targets. They started with the South China Sea, and now they have reached the Arabian Sea. What is the Pakistan government doing, you may ask? It is busy being insulted at the United Nations. Let's tell you about the latest instance. Pakistan wanted the United Nations to designate Indians as global terrorists. It failed. Five countries blocked Pakistan's move at the United Nations Security Council. Just look at the audacity here. A country which is consistently being grey-listed by the FATF for failing to curb terror tried declaring Indians as terrorists. The plan did not work, though. Pakistan submitted the names of four Indians for designation under 1267 Sanctions Committee of the UNSC. The Indians in question, and we have their names, were Angara Apaji, Gobinda Patnaik, Ajoy Mistry and Venu Madhav Dongara. They were all working in Afghanistan with private companies. Islamabad said that these men were funding terror groups in Pakistan. The names of two men were already rejected earlier. The other two have also been cleared now. The UNSC committee did not find any evidence to substantiate Pakistan's claim. The United Kingdom, the United States, France, Germany and Belgium, these five countries took the lead and they blocked Pakistan's request. So Chinese ships at its coasts, protests on its soil and setbacks at international platforms. It's been another difficult week for Pakistan.